Today we're going to be working in section 1.4, and in section 1.4 what we're going to be dealing with are, you're going to get introduced to some fundamental identities, and we're going to start verifying a few identities here in this section. So the first thing we need to do is we just need to go through and start talking about some of your identities. And we talked about a couple in the previous section with some reciprocal identities, but first off, let's just kind of define or talk about what we mean by an identity. An identity This is an equation that is true for all elements in the domain. Now again, we've already looked at a couple of identities from the previous section, but they have them here in your book on page 32. If you'll look on page 32, you'll see there the reciprocal identities. Now, your reciprocal identities are the sine of theta is equal to 1 over the cosecant of theta, which means that the cosecant of theta has to be equal to 1 over sine theta. Sine and cosecant are reciprocals of each other. All right, cosine is the reciprocal of secant, or cosine is 1 over secant. Secant theta would have to be equal to what? 1 over cosine. Tangent theta is equal to 1 over cotangent theta, and cotangent theta would be the same thing as 1 over tangent theta. And those are your reciprocal identities. Now, the next set of identities we want to talk about are the ratio identities, and they're also called the quotient identities in other books, and those are there in your book 2 on page 32. Now, your ratio or quotient identities, these are the tangent of theta is equal to the sine of theta over cosine theta. And what was tangent? Tangent was y over x. What does sine refer to? Y, and what do cosine refer to? X. So, tangent is sine over cosine. Tangent is also secant over cosecant. Cotangent, which is the reciprocal of tangent, would be cosine over sine, or cosecant over secant. Now, those are your ratio or quotient identities. Now, the next set of identities are the very important ones. You'll use them a lot in this course. You'll use them a lot in calculus. They are your Pythagorean identities, the Pythagorean identities. Now, the first Pythagorean identity here is sine squared plus cosine squared is going to equal 1. Sine squared theta plus cosine square theta equals 1. Now, there are two alternate forms here. Okay? There are two alternate forms. One is cosine square theta is equal to 1 minus sine square theta. What would sine square theta have to equal? If I move the cosine squared over, it would be what? 1 minus cosine square theta. Now, these are alternate forms of that Pythagorean identity, and they're very important. You're going to use them a lot. Okay? All right, your next Pythagorean identity is tangent square theta plus 1 equals secant square theta. Now, what do you think one of your alternatives would be here? Wouldn't 1 have to equal what? Secant square theta minus tangent square theta, right? What would tangent square theta have to equal? Secant square theta minus, you would just bring the 1 over, and that's what tangent square theta would have to be. Is everybody all right so far? All right, the last Pythagorean, and again, these are alternate forms that you'll see a lot. Now, your last set of Pythagorean identities, or the last Pythagorean identity, and it's got some alternate forms, is 1 plus cotangent square theta equals cosecant square theta. One of the alternates would be what? Cotangent square theta equals cosecant square theta minus 1. And the other one would be cosecant square theta minus cotangent square theta has to equal 1. Take a minute and copy those, because they don't give you the alternate forms there in your book. Now, there's one thing you need to know here, is that when you see sine square theta, this means the sine of theta squared. Same thing with cosine square theta. This means cosine theta squared and so on. We just put the square here so that it doesn't look like the angle is what's being squared. Does everybody follow me? Does everybody understand what sine square theta means? Tangent square theta? All right, y'all ready to try to verify some identities? Turn in your book to page 35 and look at number 16. Now, when you're verifying identities, what you're doing is you're manipulating one side of the equal sign to make it look like the other side of the equal sign. Okay? You're trying to manipulate one side to make it equal the other side. A very important thing, you never move things across the equal sign. Okay? Remember how when you solve an equation, you can divide by 3, or you can add x, or you can add 2, or whatever? You don't do that. When you're verifying an identity, think of that equal sign right there as a wall. All right? Think of that right there as a wall. Nothing from here can move over there. Nothing from over there can move over here. You have to manipulate this to make it equal that. Does everybody understand what I'm saying here? You can't add anything to both sides. You can't subtract anything from both sides. You can't multiply anything on both sides. You can't divide anything on both sides. You strictly work with one side. Does everybody follow me? Now, when you look at this, I want to manipulate this to get it to be secant square theta. Now, what do I know about secant squared theta? Secant square theta is what? Tangent square theta plus 1, isn't it? R1 plus tangent squared. Well, let's see what's going to happen. I'm going to distribute my tangent here. And what is tangent times tangent? Isn't it tangent squared? Now, what do we know about tangent? I mean, and cotangent. Cotangent is what? The reciprocal of tangent. So what are you going to end up getting right here? What's tangent times 1 over tangent? Very good, 1. And why do we know that 1 plus tangent squared is equal to? That's your Pythagorean identity. And there we have verified. Do you see how we didn't move anything across the equal sign? We didn't add anything. We didn't subtract anything. We didn't multiply. What do? We manipulated this to get it to equal this side. This is called verifying identities. Most students hate this, but I love it. These are really fun. They're like doing a puzzle. If you like doing puzzles, those analytical things where you got to think, these will make you think. All right, you ready to do another one? Look at number 22 on page 35. And what I've done is I'm mixing them up here so that you can see to verify one identity, to do another one, you may have to do something totally different. Here, we were able to distribute, right? But when you look at number 22 there on page 35, here we're given sine square theta, cotangent square theta, plus sine square theta has to equal 1. Now, all of this right here has got to somehow clean up to give me a 1 here. Does everybody follow me? Now, there's a couple of ways you could do this one. What do you know about cotangent? Cotangent is what? Okay, and it's also, think of one of your quotient identities. It's cosine over sine, isn't it? Isn't cotangent cosine over sine? Now, I'm going to work this problem two different ways, and then I'll let y'all see if you can think of another way. One thing you could do is cotangent here is the same thing as cosine over sine. Now, what's going to happen to your sine squares there? And why do we know about cosine squared plus sine squared? And we're done, right? See how quick and easy that was? Now again, that's one way to do this problem. All right, you ready to look at an alternate way to do it? All right. Somebody tell me, what do you recognize that you can factor out there? Very good. A lot of times, look and see if you can factor something out because that would help you. All right, I can factor out what here? I can factor out a sine square, which leaves me cotangent square theta plus 1, right? What is cotangent squared plus 1? Look at your Pythagorean identities. What's cotangent squared plus 1? Very good. It's cosecant squared. And what do we know about cosecant squared? Cosecant squared, or you could substitute in for sine squared. What do we know about these two? They are reciprocals of each other. So what are you going to get when you multiply here? just a little bit. So does everybody see the two different ways you could work this problem? When you're verifying identities, there's a lot of ways to do them, all right? There's not one set way, okay? Is everybody following? As long as it's logical, it's okay. Don't go making up crap as you go through these, which I see a lot of times. All right? Does everybody see two ways to do 22? Does anybody think of another way to do 22? All right, I didn't think so. All right, what about 24? Look at problem 24. Number 24, we have the sine of theta, cosine theta, plus cosine theta, all this over sine theta plus sine square theta. And we want this to equal cotangent theta. Now, when I look at this one, what jumps out at me is I have a cosine in common in the numerator, and what do I have in common in my denominator? A sine. So let's factor out the cosine in the numerator, and that's going to leave me what? Sine theta plus 1. And what can you factor out of your denominator? A sine theta, which leaves me what? 1 plus sine theta, and lo and behold, what do you notice cancels out there? Isn't sine theta plus 1 the same thing as 1 plus sine theta? By commutative property of addition, those are the same. And what do you know about cosine over sine? What's that equal? It's one of your quotient identities. So what is cosine over sine? Cotangent. Very good. Isn't that cool? All right, let's do number 30 there on page, what page is that on, 36? Now, they're getting a little more complicated here. Those first ones we done were the baby ones, all right? And that was your hors d'oeuvres, all right? Your hors d'oeuvres, now we're getting to the main meal here, okay? Now, think about what I'll tell students to think about. I know secant is 1 over cosine, if that's going to help me in a minute, and then I got 2 sine theta. I'm going to work on this side over here. 1 plus tangent theta squared. That means 1 plus tangent theta times 1 plus tangent theta, or you could use what, which would be quicker and easier. Use your bunny. 1 times 1 is 1. 1 times tangent is tangent theta. Tangent theta times 1 is tangent theta. And, I don't know why I put that there. What's tangent theta times tangent theta? Over secant theta. Now again, you could copy that over and FOIL it, or what I did there was just use the bunny method. Does everybody follow me? Does everybody remember the bunny method? Okey-doke. So now, this would end up being 1 plus 2 tangent theta plus tangent square theta. Do you see one of your identities anywhere in there? Now sometimes you kind of have to look around. What do you see about 1 plus tangent square theta? What is that 1 plus tangent square theta? Very good. What in 1 plus tangent squared, and what I'll do is I'll put these together here. So that you can see this. You don't have to put this step in here. I'm just grouping them together. So you can see that that right there now is what? Secant square theta, isn't it? Now, is everybody with me to there? 1 plus tangent squared is my secant squared. Does everybody agree? Now, what do I need? I need secant plus 2 sine theta. When you look right here, if I rewrite secant squared over secant and 2 tangent theta over secant, my secant squared over secant will reduce to secant, and then hopefully this over here will clean up to give me what? Your 2 sine theta. Let's see if it does. All right. Again, if I write secant squared theta over secant theta plus 2 tangent theta over secant theta. What's secant square over secant going to be? Because secant goes into secant square secant times, right? It'd be like x squared divided by x, right? Now, this is the same thing as 2 tangent theta times 1 over secant theta. Does everybody agree? What's a quotient identity for tangent? Secant over cosecant. You could have actually, we could have written this as sine over cosine, and 1 over secant is the same thing as what? Cosine. You could have gone that route. There's a lot of ways you can do these. What's going to cancel here? Secant. And you're going to get 2 times 1 over cosecant. And what's 1 over cosecant? One over cosecant is sine, isn't it? That was a longer one, wasn't it? Now again, you could have done a little different things in here. Right here with 2 tangent times 1 over secant, that could have been sine over cosine. 1 over secant is cosine. Then your cosines would have canceled and you would have been at 2 sine. Is everybody, see, there's a lot of different ways you can look at these. All right. Let's do another one. Look at number 36 on page 36. We've got secant alpha minus tangent square alpha over secant alpha equals cosine of alpha. Now this is one where you want to get a common denominator. What's your common denominator of 1 in secant alpha? So 1 goes into secant alpha how many times? Secant alpha, and what's secant alpha times secant alpha? Secant square alpha. Now again, 1 times what gives me secant alpha is secant alpha times secant alpha is secant squared alpha. Does everybody see how that becomes secant square alpha? Now what do you know about secant square alpha minus tangent square alpha? Look at your identities. Find secant square minus tangent squared and tell me what that equals. Very good. What's it equal? And what's 1 over secant? Is it 1 over secant the same thing as what? Cosine, isn't it? It's your reciprocal. See, aren't these fun? Do y'all think you want to do another one? All right, let's do, say, problem number, let's go up there and do an ugly one. Look at number 40 on page 36. And it may not be ugly. Put a little makeup on it and it might look fine. Page 36. Now, one thing you could do is go ahead and get a common denominator if you wanted to. Okay, that's one thing. Another thing would be you could try to look to see if possibly you could maybe clean some of this up a little bit and get your common denominator afterwards. I mean, that's up to you. There's a lot of different things you could do with this one. Y'all tell me something you want to do. You want to just go ahead and get the common denominator? Okay. See, I've been doing these for, what, 20-something years. I would have rewritten that secant as 1 over cosine and put the cosecant up there, and then I would have been in the home stretch a little bit here, but, you know, that's okay. So cosine theta, cosecant theta. So this ends up being what? Cosecant square theta, because you had cosine times what gave me cosine cosecant. I need to multiply that by cosecant, right? Minus, I had the secant theta times cosine theta, right? Somebody agree? Yes. Because my common denominator here is both of those, and I didn't have the cosecant here, so you got to do cosecant times cosecant. Are you sure? It would be like, you know, if you had, say, A over B minus C over A, then you got to multiply A times A. Okay. So now, what do you notice in your numerator? What's secant times cosine? What's secant times cosine going to be? Well, isn't secant the same thing as 1 over cosine? And what's cosecant down here? 1 over sine. And you'll see why I'm going this route in just a minute. Now, identities are one of these things. Try something. If it doesn't work, go to the next page. Don't look at what you did before and try something else. All right? Don't just sit there and stare at them and hope divine intervention is going to pop them into your head how to do them. If you don't practice something, they're not going to work. And you may try something and it doesn't work. All right? There's nothing wrong with that. Then try something else. Now, the reason why I wanted to do this is I know that this now is cosecant square theta minus 1 over cosine theta over sine theta. What is cosecant square minus 1, somebody? One of your Pythagorean identities. Cotangent squared. And what's cosine over sine? It's one of your quotient identities. What's cosine over sine? And what's cotangent squared divided by cotangent? God, girl, what are you eating, rocks? So does everybody see how it's going to be cotangent? Does everybody see this one? All right, that gives you a few of those to look at. Let's look at one problem like number 48 here. Let's get away from identities for a few minutes before y'all start crying. Mr. Harris likes identities, though. Most of the teachers here do. The main thing is you've just learned the identities, all right, and what they're wanting you to do is practice with them. And that's what verifying identities helps you start learning them, all right? But look, if you look at 48 on page 36, here they're telling you that the sine of theta is equal to 12 over 37. And they're telling you that theta is in quadrant 2. And what they want you to do is find all six trig functions, which we already know. If sine theta is 12 over 37, what's cosecant theta? 37 over 12. So we need to find cosine. Then we can find secant. We need to find tangent, because then that will give me what? Cotangent. But what is sine equal to? Sine is what, somebody? Y over R, isn't it? So what would Y have to be here? 12, and what would R have to equal? 37, because remember sine is Y over R. So how could you find X here? Well, what do we know? We know that r is equal to the square root of x squared plus y squared. So wouldn't r squared be the same thing as x squared plus y squared, right? So if you plug in, you're going to end up getting, trust me, when you bring all this over, you get 1225 equals x squared, so x here is equal to 35. Because 37 squared minus 144 squared would end up being 1225, which is going to, square root of that is 35. Just trust me, all right? Because we're running out of time. So what would cosine be? Now be careful. What quadrant are we in? 2. So what's x going to have to be here? So cosine would be negative 35 over 37. What would secant be? Negative 37 over 35. What's tangent? 12 over negative 35. And what's cotangent? Negative 35 over 12. You've got to be careful about your signs because of the quadrants there. Okie doke. Now, I'm not going to lie to you. Identities are a little rough. Okay, they've not given you any really, really ugly ones here in this section yet. Okay, now some of these you're going to have to think. All right, so do the best that you can with these. All right, on section 1.4 here. All right, they don't give you a lot of them. I'm telling you, they're just getting your feet wet for what's going to come later on. All right, any questions on 1.4? Anyone? We all right here?